Welcome to Car Questions. What we have here is a blend door module out of a Ford product. And this is what makes the car able to go from cold to hot when you turn the little knob on your dashboard. And this is out of a Ford Ranger 2010, but you'll find these things on all kinds of Fords and Ford Explorer, etc. from, you know, 2006, 2010. And this is the one, again, that changes from, you know, cold to hot. And it's coming on fall now, and people are turning things to hot, and they're going, hey, what happened? Everything's working great. The blower motor, the AC worked fine this summer. All of a sudden, you go to turn to hot, not working. So first thing you have to do, of course, is check fuses, make sure nothing's blown, make sure you have enough coolant in your car or truck, and make sure a valve under the hood that controls coolant flow is allowing coolant to get to the heater core. Now, if all that's okay, and especially if you don't have a blown fuse, and all the other controls work fine, the blower motor's working, and fan speeds are going, it's directing the air up and down, but you're not getting the hot, then this is suspect. And let me show you what the reason is. I've taken this one out of the car, and it's a hell of a job to get at it in a lot of these cars, and they will charge a good buck. You can take it apart yourself if you want. It has a series of about 8 clips on it. I've already had this one apart, so it's going to come apart easily. Just use a little penknife, pop it apart. There's 8 little clips on the side of it. There we go. And we'll take the module apart. And all it is just a little motor, little DC motor right there that, you know, turns this and turns that right there, and that opens and closes a door on your HVAC system and allows heat to come in or to stay out. It has a little electrical connector right there. A lot of times you open this up and you're gonna find stripped gears right here. And when that happens, the motor works. You hear click, click, click. You'll hear this kind of noise. If that's what you're hearing, then these gears are stripped and you can take them apart and have a look. And that's what happens to them. Now, ours wasn't doing that. No noise, no nothing, no blown fuses. So I decided, let's have a close look at this thing. And of course, I've already had this apart. I took a little DC motor out of it, and we popped the back off because I want to look at the brushes. Something's the matter with this, and it's a permanent magnet motor. And they're pretty simple devices. And of course, there you have it. Now, right there, it's supposed to have 2 brushes going to the armature. It turns out on these things, they're so cheaply made, they're just little bits of wire, and they're quite easily damaged, and they just fall apart. Just like that. You can see it. Just little bits of wire, and they're gone. So that's why this one's failed. That's why these things typically go. The armature, the brushes that work the motor, disintegrate. This part costs about $120 in Canada from a Ford dealer. I think you get them online for $60 or something like that. And fix your Ford. This repair can cost hundreds of dollars, $700-$800. You just took the dealership and said, hey, I'm not getting in hot air. And that was the issue, this module. And of course, the thing that failed, the mystery is, in this particular one, it was the brushes and the motor. Everything else is fine. It's just very poor design, very poor design. And again, another common issue on these modules is the gear strip. But that's the Ford blend door module motor component. You can get them online. There's people selling them aftermarket. Good for them. And that's the issue. If you don't have a blown fuse, everything else is okay in the car, that's it. So, anyway, another mystery solved. Thanks for watching Car Questions, and please subscribe.